A few years ago, our lives got turned upside down, and I found myself unexpectedly filling the role of mother, father, and friend for my children. Unfortunately, the trauma we were experiencing directly affected my 13-year-old daughter, Mia, and I knew that I couldn't help her alone. I reached out to big brothers and big sisters, and shortly after, Mia got matched with her big sister, Krista.
Mia and I will have been matched 3 years this December.
We had just gone through a really big life-changing experience and just moved and everything, so my mom wanted to make sure I had a really good support system.
It simultaneously feels like it's been 3 years, but also 30 years, and then also 3 months. Time is kind of weird and meaningless these last couple years.
I was very nervous of just someone new coming in my life.
I remember walking into their apartment and sitting at the table. Our counselor and Mia's mom were hitting it off real great, and Mia and I were just kind of staring at each other from across the table. We were each a little too afraid to say the first word.
I thought it would be very awkward. We wouldn't have anything to talk about. But then once we got together, it was super fun, a lot of laughs, and we definitely clicked right away.
So I think we mostly based our activities off of my favorite hobbies.
I did not know libraries had cooking classes, and it was so fun.
It was definitely a lot of baking and crafting. Dragged you to the dog park once or twice.
I never heard of Hamilton before. He called me and my mom telling me that she got Hamilton tickets. I did not want to go at all at first. I just thought I would find it boring because it was 3 hours long. But I loved it, and it was just nice to have a new experience.
It wasn't just a relationship between me and Mia, it was between me and her mom, and spending time with her brother, and her stepdad, and the dogs. That was definitely something that I was not anticipating, but it's been really nice. We were actually at a Big Brothers Big Sisters event. I was at a seminar with Vanessa, her mom, and the seminar was how to talk to your teen about sex. And it was after that educational course that Vanessa told me we were a little bit too late and Mia was pregnant.
I was very nervous and anxious overall what to think about it because I had a baby growing inside of me. I was about to become a mother, so I was very nervous, but Krista was there for me all of the time.
I was completely taken aback. I had no idea. I was not expecting that. But I remember talking to Vanessa for about an hour and a half afterwards, where she laid out all the different options that we had in front of us. And I think together we were feeling pretty good that, yeah, we've got a game plan. We're going to make sure Mia gets through this. The main goals were Mia stays healthy and stays happy and stays in school.
I remember she did a lot of research, texting me very often, new updates about the baby, books I should read.
I went on my honeymoon not long after, and I brought, I think, 6 different books on pregnancy. So I was sitting poolside in Mexico reading all about pregnancy and what to expect when you're expecting.
And then I went to a lot of classes to help, and I remember Chris always being there for me.
So we really wanted to make sure that she was still going to graduate high school and go on to college. Like, that was her original game plan. We know it's going to be tough, but we've got a plan.
Krista was a big part in helping why I stayed in school, because I started failing in math and chemistry. And then while with the whole pandemic and us doing virtual, she would meet up with me once a week on Zoom to help me with my homework. And I actually passed thanks to her. I had Layla on March 31st of 2020, and then Krista got pregnant.
Actually, a couple months later, your mom got pregnant.
Oh, yeah.
I remember she told me she was pregnant, and I knew I was pregnant at the time, but I wasn't telling anybody yet, so I kind of sat on that for a little bit. And then I told you guys about a month after that, I think. So 2 weeks after Mia's mom had her baby, I had my twins. The first thing Mia told me was, oh my gosh, I have so much advice for you. And she rattled off a whole bunch of different resources that I should look into and a whole bunch of different things to know about babies and being pregnant. And it was a pretty cool feeling knowing that, hey, you know, maybe she's the big in the relationship at this point. Now that we're feeling more comfortable about meeting up together outside and we've got little ones who should enjoy the fresh air, one of the things that we'd been meaning to do all summer was take all the kids to the playground. So a couple weeks ago, we met up and her mom was able to join us with her baby. And so the 3 of us moms and our 4 children all went to the playground. It was really nice. We sat on the picnic table. We had our own little mini moms group, and you know, babies were all sleeping quietly in their baby carriers, except for Layla, who was going up and down the slide about 100 times, I think.
I definitely want to go to college, and I wanted to be a registered nurse, but then after having Layla and having that amazing support group while being in labor, I decided I wanted to be like a labor and delivery nurse, because I just loved how much they made me feel like comfortable and how much they helped me.
This has been such a positive experience in my life. Definitely not always easy. A lot of challenges thrown my way, a lot of self-doubt that I've had to tackle as well. But coming through it on the other side and having this awesome new relationship and awesome new family that I'm part of, it's a really, really good experience.
Mia and I treasure our relationship with Krista and are so thankful she has become part of our family. We are truly blessed to have Krista, and we're very grateful. We love her.